record, this is not anything I would normally do. This was never on my bucket list. This was Stephen's idea.
Driving to the Shark Cage people with our rental. Sailing around South Africa is never going to be the same again for us because we're going to see what's swimming underneath our boat.
So this is my, I've said this before, if I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. I just don't think about what I'm going to do before I'm going to do it until like 3 seconds before I'm going to do it. So as of now, I'm just going to observe diving with the sharks. And if maybe the courage comes over me to get into the water, then I will, but no pressure. No pressure.
I hope I don't pass out again this time.
Oh, fainty Susan over here. Yeah. He's the one that keeps like never turned down an adventure, and he's passing out, he's blacked out on the dive off the bridge, then he falls off his horse. I'm the one peeing my pants and he's the one unconscious. Perfect. Okay. Well, thank you for the great white shark adventure, right?
White Shark Africa, I think.
White Shark Africa, Africa.
And they're in Mossel Bay.
Yep, they're in Mossel Bay. We were gonna put in all of their details and they were super nice to get us on this boat. They had an engine go out on one of their vessels and so they're just packed to the brim with clients because this is the only place right now in South Africa where you can see white sharks at this time.
Because the orcas came through and they just chased away all the white sharks in Hans Bay. So everybody's coming here and I'm told they have about 300 resident white sharks that just lurks in these waters. And so
can you not use the word lurks before we get in?
Do-do.
Stop, don't, no, seriously, don't make that noise song before.
Do-do-do-do.
Stop it! I'm not even kidding right now. Okay, that's where the seals, that's where lunch lives. That's not where lunch lives. This isn't where lunch lives. There he is.
Captain Monkey's lion.
I think that we're gonna have no problem seeing sharks because we smell delicious.
Chicken.
Yeah, she took
both. I'm stuck.
Push.
So do you think we're going out on a sailboat?
No.
Dang it.
I don't know why they put a cage on a sailboat.
Oh. You make a good point.
So what's up?
Oh, not much, eh?
How's it been going?
Lekker, dude.
Yeah.
Beautiful weather.
Yeah.
We had some nice southeast come through, big swells, but it was lekker, dude.
Yeah, I felt that wind come through last night.
Yeah. Well, last night's wind actually settled the ocean a bit.
Oh, is it?
Huge swells the previous 2 days.
Cool. Nice. And what's the possibility of seeing them big boys?
The big boys, yeah. I don't know so much about the big boys, but the juveniles will definitely
be there.
Yeah. We had 4 sharks on the first trip, 2 on the second. So let's hope for 6 on this one, eh?
Cool, yeah.
Thank you. I swear to God. I promise you.
You look so delicious.
Thank you.
Firstly, welcome to Thrift Rock. This is the reef where we're going to be working from. As you can see on the right hand side there, Alan's already started chumming for us. Basically, it's a bunch of mashed up fish. Got some salmon in there and some other mixed up fish. So give it a nice mash, get all the oils and the juices out, add seawater to that, throw it back out. It's going to create a nice oil slick on the water. It's going to go towards the beach. The sharks are up and down the surf line over there, so when they smell it, they'll get curious, they'll move towards a boat. This is the most dangerous part of the cage dive, is getting in and out of the cage. You don't want to make any mistakes there. You don't want to end up on the other side of the cage. That wouldn't be too fun. You can see this cage is bruised, battered and bent. Very important to keep your hands on those inside bars. These are powerful, powerful animals.
Okay, the non-wetsuit wearing folks are going in first. It ain't me.
Go!
Shuck, 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 shuck.
Shuck, 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 shuck.
Oh, he's dead! Oh my God!
There you go!
I can get you into a suit quick.
Yeah, I'll get in a suit quick.
Come on, Abby, come on.
Okay, I'm getting in. I'm getting in.
Like strangers with no heart. Stuck
in way clearer than half a day.
Yeah!
Okay, that was way more terrifying than jumping off a 716-foot bridge. Oh my gosh, I was shaking. That was so crazy, so crazy. Okay, so the most horrifying part for me was realizing that my foot was on the wrong bar.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So it wasn't on the bar that it was supposed to be on.
Think about it. Even if it was on that bar, there was never a chance that it was going to bite you.
It was never a chance, but it's still scary.
Yeah, it's
I'm watching the people
animal.
Below right
beautiful,
now.
Beautiful, beautiful creature.
Gorgeous animal. And it's weird. It kind of looks at you like a dog, but it's not interested in eating you.
It's just graciously like, it's a very scary looking thing, but it's beautiful. Same question.
At White Rock Africa, we're working more towards the conservation side of the white rocks. Also, we want to show the people this amazing animal, and it's majestic.
Amazing. Whoa, whoa. Some people will say, amazing. Wait, that's a killing machine. Is it a killing machine? Yes, it is. But why would you say it's an amazing animal and people shouldn't fear it?
Because if you go and look at a white rock, and for instance, we get 2, 3, 4 sharks around the boats, and each shark would have a different personality, an individual personality like humans would have. And for instance, one shark will come around the boat, they'll see the bait, and he would just be inquisitive. He'll want to figure out, what is this thing floating in the ocean with this nice smell around it? Basically the same thing as you going into a kitchen smelling a good steak. And you expect to see a steak. So now if a shark veers in and he smells that lovely fish, he sees a tuna head, obviously he recognizes the tuna head, so then he knows, okay, that's my steak. The main reason I believe sharks, people get bitten is because, say now you're in the ocean, your heart's beating a lot. Shark can feel that on because of that got that ampullar Lorenzine that picks up the electromagnetic heart rate. So they feel all this energy, they want to figure out what it is. They veer in closer, they're very inquisitive animals, very curious like a cat. And he would think, okay, that could be food, and he'll do an exploratory bite. And because we are so frail, all our arteries are on the outer side of our body, and
we die
unfortunately. But that doesn't make the shark this ruthless killer. Of course they are very powerful, they are made to hunt effectively, that is what they do. But if you had to go look at a shark hunt a seal and a shark bite a human, two completely different things.
Oh really?
A shark rips a seal apart completely, and where a shark would just go to a human,
it's usually like a bite,
just a bite, you'll have
like a little love bite.
Exactly. This is the most feared shark in the ocean, and we want to be able to change people's perspectives about these animals. They aren't these ruthless killers as people think they are, and they aren't man eaters, they also eat women and children. Just kidding, guys, just kidding.
Ah, oh, good to know. My chances are declining to getting eaten.
People are killing the sharks and taking off their fins and making soup.
Yes.
I don't eat shark fin soup, but what can I do to help?
These shark fins, they don't have any nutrition for us. That's the most important thing people need to grasp firstly. I mean, why go pay $100 for a bowl of soup if it's got no nutrition for you at all?
It's like eating an ear.
It's like eating the ear, essentially. Like, precisely the same thing for biting your nails. You might as well do that. Now, what you guys could do at home is, if you go to a restaurant and a seafood restaurant, ask them, check out your menu, if you can check out their menu. And if you see they've got any shark
product
on there at all, just turn around, walk away, explain to them maybe why you are now walking away, because you don't want to support the trade of shark fins, because it's a lot of sharks being killed every day.
All right, thank Salmon's you so much. Good. Thank you so much, very cool.
Thank you guys. Keep fins alive.
Donna, Donna, I wanted to-
Oh, now you're allowed to
I wanted to kill Stefan when he was like, Donna, 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 I'm getting in the cage. I'm like, I swear, if you give me one more bar of that song, I am not getting in that cage right now. It is like, the thing that made me not swim, one of the things, but the main thing is that song, that movie, that is, wow.
That movie wasn't good for the sharks.
No, that movie was really bad for the sharks. Today, I cannot lie and say that I am not absolutely terrified of sharks. They are huge, they're beautiful, they're toothy. I wouldn't want to be on the other side of the cage, but I learned such a valuable thing about the shark's place in the ecosystem. If we lose the sharks, we have so many seals. And if we have so many seals, they're going to eat all of the fish. And if we have no fish, then we have nothing to clean the reefs. And if we lose our reefs, the ocean gets dirty, and then humanity is just really screwed. So sharks are a very valuable part of our ecosystem. So protect them, check your menus, and you're not on it. You're definitely not on it. It's an exploratory bite, which would suck, but you are less safe in your car than you are swimming in the ocean or sailing on the sea. So sharks are super cool. I'm not gonna lie, I'm still scared.
All right, you guys.
Peace out! Ka-ka! Smell my hands. Cool. Ready?
I'm ready.
You're with Carlos and Fauna.
Cheers, man.
Cheers. Hey, what do
you think? Cheers.
To the sharks.
To the sharks.
Think about becoming one of our Patreon family.
For all the behind the scenes of these girls, what they're doing on the boat, the uncut and the full version, go check them out on Vimeo.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week on Sailing Miss Lone Star. Maybe we'll make a deal. Maybe together we can go somewhere, any place.